dog.
Hi guys. It is an absolutely spectacularly gorgeous, over the top beautiful day here in the end times in Trumpville, USA. That is, would be Dunellen, Florida, the ground zero the Donald Trump support army on this glorious, it is a Monday. It is Monday, April 1st, 2024, April Fool's Day, 2024. I cannot think of a better day to bring you my weekly Dump the Trumptyhive Roundup rant. Dump the Trumptyhive Roundup rant than April Fool's Day. And guys, I'm gonna start changing this rant a little bit. Instead of just touching on 25 of these pleas to the universe to get this guy out of here before November 5th, I'm just going to concentrate on a couple of my favorite from the mainstream media and from medium.com. Now, of course, it being April Fool's, you've probably already heard that Donald Trump, the jokester Donald Trump, got up this morning, and good for you, Donald, and posted on his little Truth Social, whatever, that he was suspending his campaign. That Donald Trump, suspending my campaign. But of course, he came back 10 minutes later and said, ha ha ha, April Fools. So anyway, after that brief fantasy that Donald Trump is voluntarily abandoning the campaign trail, we're going to hear from two voices. And wow, this little dog puts his voice on that lizard over there like that. And we're going to start over at Slate Magazine. At Slate Magazine. I don't know if this is... It was on Yahoo News a few days ago. Now, this is a long, long piece. I'm going to put the link on it in case you're really undecided whether or not you want to vote for Donald Trump. This is a fellow named David Ferris on Slate Magazine on Yahoo News talking about the unimaginable horror of a Trump restoration. I'm going to skip over the opening and just read a few picks from this good Lord book length essay. A Trump restoration is in the works, and it should feel like an existential threat to everyone who cares about liberal democracy and the incomplete but tangible social, racial, and economic progress that has been made since the New Deal era. And yet, President Joe Biden's manifest flaws are dangerously obscuring the scale of the threat of a second Trump term. There is no sense in denying it. Joe Biden looks and sounds very old, and his speaking style, never particularly inspirational, has deteriorated to the point that Biden is a clear political liability. Joe Biden's decision to run for a second term has put the very existence of U.S. democracy at much more serious risk. And guys, I'm not going to go down the rabbit hole this guy, David Ferris, knows as well as I do that this is not a democracy. Okay, we all know it is an oligarchy, that we're just using the colloquial term of democracy. So I don't need your tired old, man, it's not a democracy. We know it's a fucking oligarchy, okay? And as the Slate article is pointing out, there is one human on this planet that we can thank for Donald Trump, the resurrection of Donald Trump, and it is not Donald Trump, it is Joe Biden. Joe Biden is the reason that that we're where we are right now. That old fuck's refusal to get out of the fucking way and let somebody serious come in there. But anyway, the damage has been done, and now here we are because of that old fucker, Joe Biden. This is the fucking mess we've gotten in. Anyway, he correctly goes on and on ranting about Joe Biden before he gets back to Donald Trump. So after all of this, yeah, we realize that Joe Biden is what he is. Nevertheless, allowing Donald Trump and his friends to plunge our country into a dystopian nightmare of authoritarianism will not help anyone in Gaza, in the grocery store, or at the border. It will worsen, not rectify, America's history of writing blank checks to far-right governments in Israel. It will not lead to humane policy options for asylum seekers, but instead deliver them into the hands of morally bankrupt demagogues. Electing Trump would merely add more considerable suffering and trauma to theirs and deprive us all of the ability to do anything about it. Much has been made of the far-right Project 2025, a blueprint for radically restructuring and reorienting executive branch policymaking created by a network of right-wing think tanks and pressure groups, and its terrifying implications for U.S. democracy. And I put that words in quotes. But that document concerns only the threats Trump's re-election poses to executive branch agency. Myriad public dangers emanating from the Trump and GOP legislative agenda, as well as the possibility of an even harder right Supreme Court, are getting far less attention, and that needs to change. And then he just breaks all of this down. He spends a lot of time talking about if Donald Trump gets in and gets some more and gets a couple of more of his little fascist Nazi buddies on the Supreme Court, that you know, that will be fucked a lot more than 4 years. So he spends a lot. Okay, so moving on from there, much has been made of reports that Trump plans to deploy the military to quell post-election protests under the Insurrection Act. But a Trump unchained from any conceivable repercussions for his decisions in his office is a far worse threat than just that. And then he gets back to, the Supreme Court just giving Trump free reign to do what that it completely destroys any system of checks and balances. And my God, if Congress goes Republican, Trump's in the White House, and with the Supreme Court already loaded, that we're just face it. We are heading into a far right wing, basically a military dictatorship with no checks or balances on this fucking lunatic. Who or what exactly would stop Trump from, say, creating a new security apparatus, abducting leftists and political enemies, as he has pledged, and dropping them out of helicopters over the Pacific like the Latin American dictators the far right still worship once did? He could order the hits, then preemptively pardon the people who carry out his orders. That might seem melodramatic and is far-fetched, but if the Supreme Court grants him immunity, as president, no one could touch him for it legally. And if Republicans simultaneously control both chambers of commerce, there would be no impeachment option either. We have learned the hard way far too many times that a critical mass of elected Republicans will do Trump's bidding no matter how grotesque his actions. Maybe he will stop short of creating an American Stasi, but a president who is unbounded by the law could order the Department of Justice to gin up investigations of leading journalists, prominent Democrats, professors, activists, and nonprofit leaders. Independent media outlets could be acquired by allies or buried under lawsuits and government harassment. Troops could be deployed to garrison blue cities, not only to find and deport immigrants, but also chill and repress any dissident fervor that develops in the aftermath of his takeover. He would say he's merely fighting crime, illegals, and election fraud, but Trump could conceivably place the cities he fears and despises where his political adversaries wield most of their power and influence under what amounts to an open-ended military occupation. And it gets worse. And that's talking about he's likely to bring in Republican control of the House and Senate with him, which did just completely. We're completely fucked. That means that the toxic, vengeful politics of Texas and Florida will go national. Trump showed time and time again during his first term that he was not just willing but eager to subcontract his domestic policymaking to the right-wing think tanks that write most state-level legislation for Republicans. And then we get into Agenda 47. Oh, God. You can bet we're looking at a national abortion ban. You know, and his enemies list doesn't stop there. Trump's promised militarized mass deportation effort could be just the beginning of the crackdown on both legal and illegal immigration. And get ready for a flurry of moves against the remaining redoubts of liberalism and democracy, particularly in secondary and higher education. And they won't stop there. If you're a librarian, good luck. His radical agenda would surely be accompanied by an assault on Democrats' ability to ever win another free and fair election. All the ways that he could do that. talking about you can kiss goodbye the separation of powers and the checks and balances. It is not hyperbole to say that the America that a second Trump term would create might be an almost unrecognizable realm of economic insecurity, political persecution, racist hatred, and gender tyranny, a Christian nationalist hellscape that would be virtually impossible to dismantle once it is put into place. And I'll put the link on that. Then we're going to go over from Slate Magazine to good old medium.com, which is overflowing with Trump derangement syndrome. And we are going to give today's nod to Mike Meyer. Mike Meyer, can this year get any worse? And he starts out, just going through, what we're already dealing with, not even counting Donald Trump. Okay. Even if Donald Trump wasn't in the picture, how fucked we are after the first 3 months. But moving on. And then there is Donald Trump. On top of all the catastrophes that are building up for the hottest summer on record for the Northern Hemisphere, we have Trump feeding displays of massive stupidity to the clueless capitalist media. The Trump disaster is not new, and his growing dementia has removed the last vestiges of shame. His condition is, as commonly understood, increasingly self-destructive and should be generating sympathy for his decline. We all have raised kids and grandkids, well, not all of us, and we know what a whiny 3-year-old can do to a day. But those can be put to bed for a nap and aren't asking for the ability to destroy the planet. Dealing nationally with a 250-pound angry 3-year-old with severe mental conditions has no solution. No one can control Donald Trump. And watching the destruction of those convinced they can use him for their benefit is not worth the years of disgust and embarrassment we have already had. The fact that this man was president for 4 years and was used to put political hacks on many court benches, including the Supreme Court, adds disaster that reaches the level of Greek tragedy. We need a national special prosecutor to review and remove corrupt judges. I know it can't be done. Suppose Biden and the stumbling Democratic Party gain control this November. Yeah, right. In that ain't gonna happen case, it must be demanded, along with the elimination of the Electoral College and expansion with term limits of the Supreme Court. But who wants to be the Greek chorus every day to a very poorly written tragedy that is sucking energy and oxygen out of our planetary atmosphere in the most heavily armed imperial state? Folks, that is not just a national disgrace and regional disaster, but a recipe for planetary disaster. We have problems far more significant than we can handle already, and we will be looking at days of video with Trump doing his best to outrage everyone, all while watching meaningless lies, whining, and idiocy from those people stupid enough to expect something from Trump. His seemingly endless lies and outrageous demands have come to a head. He is now seriously gagged for his first criminal trial. And then, you know, they talk about all that stuff from that gag order. So I'm going to skip over that stuff. We know that story. But this will not help and will just distract us from the enormous problems we must address immediately. We have been set up to see Trump as a valid presidential candidate instead of a pitiful spectacle to glue eyeballs to the mainstream media. At the same time, the damage has been done to our tottering system. We know the game, but have decades of addiction and cannot pull away from the capitalist drug. Trump is close to winning. Polls show less than 1 point between sanity and insanity. You know, and when a Joe Biden presidency is the definition of sanity, you know we're fucked, okay? You know we're fucked if Joe Biden is the definition of sanity. The feed, you know, the mainstream media election bullshit feed, is constant for those addicted. It has been mostly ignored by everyone else, but we are told that people are stunningly stupid and are fascinated by Trump. Several years of elections have shown that the Trump juggernaut is a clown car with whistles, but the system is dysfunctional and people now behind Trump are authoritarians undaunted by laws. Yes, but watching someone march to the gallows is fascinating. We can't look away, but the conclusion is sickening. The Trump spectacle has crossed the line. The danger now is the distraction and the ruthless fascist collaboration that has taken over the Republican Party in the name of Trump. They intend to steal this election unless they are stopped, and Trump is a problematic symbol. We all know that Trump needs to be more bright to organize anything that does not lead to failure and bankruptcy. His 2016 election was a quirk that left him amazed and befuddled. His 2020 re-election campaign was a joke. He has narcissistic fixations and grandiose delusions are worse now, yet the campaign is being managed with brutal efficiency and not by his family. I don't think he understands that at this stage. Who are these people? The Federalist Society is one clue, and essential as this has set up the corrupted courts around the country with scripts to destroy representative government covered by the usual authoritarian charade. Trump's indictments and trials are being managed for maximum distraction, like a professional wrestling exhibition. A corrupt judge suddenly reverses each near loss, and someone covers self-inflicted bankruptcy from fines and judgments with thinly disguised bailouts. Guys, this was supposed to be a 6-minute read. Anyway, I'm going on with it. Okay, let's talk about the Trump-tards or the Trumpists. The Trumpists, or as I call them, Trump-tards, we're talking about the maggots here, are a joke. These are the same people who buy wrestling and other exhibition tickets and think it is accurate. That is the reason the core Trumpists are now evangelicals and fringe Christian nationalists who can be counted on to believe this absurd, combined with the tractor pull and pro wrestling fans who love fake violence. They are not a majority, but it doesn't matter. They are a facade to claim the victory that is being arranged by people with the money and the cold cruelty to build a fascist America to rule the planet with, by far the largest military in existence. The theft of America and its empire needs to happen before the climate disaster begins to wipe out large chunks of the planet's population. The rulers think they will be safe by then, but that is another delusion. This is the threat we face, and they are faceless. Trump is a distraction and the dumb hero for the groomed electric that will never notice when the hero is replaced. The music and the fantasy action will be the same, so who cares if the face is different and the name changes? Or it is easier to do an AI virtual Trump who can be turned off when necessary. This long game dates back to the John Birch Society, Nixon and Ronald Reagan, but the schedule has been seriously disrupted by the planetary climate disaster. The billionaires behind this thought they could convince people it was not real so they could stay on schedule. But reality has proven we need more time. What was needed was another actor politician like Reagan, but Trump was pressed into service. Things are going very fast, and there is no time. The American empire needs to be taken now. It must all be done by the end of this year. We will all face climate disasters as they grow, but the plan is to leave us powerless and helpless to the forces of destruction. The irony is that Biden and the Democrats are part of the illusion. The script requires a dumb hero and a dumb anti-hero. Our media is the Greek chorus which informs us of what is happening, when, and where to look. Our faceless rulers are not original, but they know the classic formula and play it, and will play it to the bitter end. Can we take control and end this deadly farce? And obviously, the question is no, we cannot. There is no way. This whole thing is out of fucking control. We are heading into such a shit show. All this in Donald Trump too. But I need to go. I think I have a call from the FBI that I need to. I think the FBI is trying to contact me. That was quick. My guys.